tell the people of whatever this town's called. I know what's going on here, and frankly, I'm appalled. I read 3/4 of a news story and knew I had to come. And unless I am doing the miracle worker, just to do you think you are. Your prejudice and your oppression won't get past this Broadway star. Stealing the rights of a girl who is an LGBTQ teen. I've been far too angry to Google what those letters mean. But it's not about me, it's about poor Emma. For can't you see the raw deal she's been dealt? So hear my plea, or here's your next dilemma. How do you silence a woman who's known for her belt?
Sing it, Eleanor!
Her belt! But it's not about me. Get them out of here, now! Go on and threaten to riot. It won't faze me in the least. I understand the furious townfolk. I did Beauty and the Beast. I'm no stranger to slander, so my dear, you're not alone. The Post once said I was too old to play Ava Perone. Ava Perone! But it is not about me. It's Emma's story, damn it. Equality should be this country's norm. No photography unless you Instagram it. Use hashtag DD takes local yokels by storm. But it's not about me. I didn't come here to make a scene, but I know how Emma's heart aches. And this is how actors intervene through fiery songs and dance breaks. But it's not about me. Although I'm rich and famous, publicity is not my final goal.
You
needn't be some backwoods ignoramus. Join me and we'll start fighting. Could I get softer lighting? Wait, this
So remember, short people have long faces, long people have short faces, big people have little humor, and little people have no humor at all. And in the words of that immortal bard, Samuel J. Snodgrass, as he was about to be led to the guillotine, make 'em laugh, don't you know everyone wants to laugh? My dad said, be an actor, my son, but be a comical one, they'll be standing in lines for those old honky-tonk monkey shines. Now you could study Shakespeare, be quite elite, and you could charm the critics and have nothing to eat. Just slip on a banana peel, the world's at your feet. Make them laugh, make them laugh, make them laugh. Make them laugh, make them laugh. Don't you know everyone wants to laugh? Grandpa said, go out and tell them a joke, but give it plenty of hope. Make them roar, make them scream, take a full bottle, wall spin a scene. You start off by pretending you're a dancer with grace. You wiggle till they're giggling all over the place. And then you get a great big custard pie in the face. Make them laugh, make them laugh, make them laugh.
Days are so busy, it's making me dizzy. There's so much I gotta do. There's lunches and meetings and poetry readings and endless interviews. Gotta pose for a portrait and how it deplores it, and there for eternity. Then it's off to the inn where my innkeeper friend wants to name a drink after me. Then it's back to my room where I resume my attempt to write a hit. Just me and my beer and the terrible fear that I might be losing it. And it's hard,
it's hard,
it's hard,
it's hard,
it's really, really hard,
so very, very hard.
I make it look easy, but honey, believe me, it's hard,
it's hard,
it's hard,
it's hard,
it's so incredibly hard,
so
inconceivably, unbelievably hard. It's hard to be the bard. Honestly, I don't know how I do it. There's only so much of me to go around. I got so many fans with so many demands, I can hardly go take a piss.
You get me.
Be a theater freak or the autograph seeker, they all want a piece of this.
Gimme.
It's a cross that I bear, I'm like Jesus, I swear it's a burden, but I suffer through it.
Suffering.
It's all part of the game, the trappings of fame, but somebody's gotta do it.
So he does it.
And I know, I gotta go and get back to my pen and ink. Oh, don't make me do it, don't make me go through it. Can somebody get me a drink? Cause it's hard,
it's hard,
it's hard,
it's hard,
it's really,
it's
really,
really
hard.
It's sexy, but it's hard.
This bar that I'm raising to be this amazing,
it's hard,
it's hard,
it's hard,
it's hard,
it's so annoyingly hard,
so unavoidably, unenjoyably hard. It's hard to be the bard, baby. I know writing made me famous, but being famous is just so much more fun. You see, what people just don't understand is that writing's demanding, it's mentally challenging, and it's a bore. It's such a chore to sit in a room by yourself. Oh my God, I just hate it. And you're trying to find an opening line or a brilliant idea, and you're pacing the floor and hoping for just a bit of divine intervention. That one little nugget, that one little spark, then eureka, you find it, you're ready to start. So now you can write, right? Wrong, you're not even close. You remember the damage. Your place gotta be an iambic pentameter. So you write down a word, but it's not the right word. So you try a new word, but you hate the new word. And you need a good word, but you can't find the word. Oh, where is it? What is it? What is it? Where is it?
Hello. You asked for information on what Nicholas Bottom is writing. Our spy is here with the news.
Did he see me losing it?
He's half blind, sir.
Oh, good. Then he only saw half of it. You see what I did?
Oh, yes, yes, yes. Wonderful.
Speak, man, what news?
I saw Nick Bottom, I did. He paid a soothsayer to foresee what Shakespeare's greatest play would be. that sneaky little thief. Why doesn't he come up with his own ideas?
It's hard.
No, it is, isn't it?
It's really the worst.
It's hard.
Makes me wonder why I didn't think of that first.
It's hard.
To alleviate the pressure to create.
It's hard.
To do something as good as the last thing I did that was already great.
It's hard.
It's hard.
So hard that he is stealing from the bar.
Well, I'll hoist Elias Baton.
All that I need is a clever disguise.
I'll
make him pay for his devious lies. Make him do all the tedious stuff. The work that's terribly and unbearably hard. Nick Bottom, I think Shakespeare needs to find out what Shakespeare's next big hit will be. Cause it's hard.
It's hard, it's totally hard.
It's hard.
It's hard, it's totally hard.
It's hard.
It's hard, it's totally hard.
Fortune and fame, everyone knows my name. I can't help it, it's still frickin' hard.
Homework!
Yeah. A book report on Peter Rabbit.
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 Peter Rabbit is the stupid book about the stupid rabbit who steals vegetables from other people's gardens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 83 to go.
The name of the book about which this book report is about is Peter Rabbit, which is about this rabbit. I found it very... I liked the part where... It was a... It reminded me of Robin Hood.
And the part where Little John jumped from the rock to the Sheriff of Nottingham's back. And then Robin and everyone swung from the trees in a sudden surprise attack. And they captured the Sheriff and all of his goods, and they carried him back to this camp in the woods. And the Sheriff was guest at their dinner and all, but he wriggled away and he sounded the call. And his men rushed in and the arrows flew.
Peter Rabbit did sort of that kind of thing too.
The other people's name was McGregor. 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23.
In examining a work such as Peter Rabbit, it is important that the superficial characteristics of its deceptively simple plot should not be allowed to blind the reader to the more substantial fabric of its deeper motivations. In this report, I plan to discuss the sociological implications of family pressures so great as to drive an otherwise moral rabbit to perform acts of thievery which he consciously knew were against the law. I also hope to explore the personality of Mr. McGregor in his conflicting roles as farmer and humanitarian. Peter Rabbit is established from the start as a benevolent hero.
If I start writing now when I'm not really rested, it could upset my thinking, which is not good at all. I'll get a fresh start tomorrow, and it's not due till Wednesday, so I'll have all of Tuesday unless something should happen. Why does this always happen? I should be outside playing, getting fresh air and sunshine. I work best under pressure, and there'll be lots of pressure if I wait till tomorrow. I should start writing now, but if I start writing now when I'm not really rested, it could upset my thinking, which is not good at all.
The name of the rabbit was Peter. 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Ha!
Down came the staff on his head, smash! And Robin fell like a sack full of lead, crash! The sheriff laughed and he left him for dead. Ha! But he was wrong.
36, 37, 38, 39, 40.
Just then an arrow flew in. Whing! It was a sign for the fight to begin. Whing! And then it looked like the sheriff would win. Ah! But not for long. Away they ran.
just like rabbits who run a lot, as you can tell from the story of Peter Rabbit, which this report is about.
Pressure exerted on him by his deeply rooted rivalry with Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail.
If I think I'm writing now, look about which this book report is about is Peter Rabbit.
Or Peter Rabbit.
We're all from one, every man has his part. First thing after this, I'll start.
And they were very, 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 very happy to be home.
The end.
94-95. The very, very, very end.
Amen.
A book report on Peter Rabbit.
Life, you know, will both of us be losing our identities? I tell him I'm an analyst about it, and he said to see him Monday, but Monday will be floating in the Hudson with the other garbage. I'm not well, so I'm not getting married. You've been swell, but I'm not getting married. Clear the hall, because I'm not getting married. Thank you all, but I'm not getting married. And don't tell Paul, but I'm not getting married today.
Thank you.
you know I adore you all, but why watch me die like Eliza on the ice? Look, perhaps I'll collapse in the abs right before you all. So take back the cake, burn your shoes and boil the rice. Look, everyone, I can tell you, but I may be coming down with hepatitis, and I think I'm gonna faint. So if you wanna see me faint, I'll do it happily. But wouldn't it be funnier to go and watch your funeral? So thank you for the 27 dinner plates, 37 butter knives, 47 paper weights, 57 cab holders.
One more thing.
I'm not getting married.
Amen.
But I'm not getting married.
Amen.
See, I'm not getting married.
Amen.
Still, I'm not getting married.
Amen.
I was praying that we're not getting married.
Sergeant Krupke, you gotta understand, it's just our bringing up key that gets us out of hand. Our mothers all are junkies, our fathers all are drunks. Golly Moses, naturally we're punks.
Gee, Officer Krupke, we're very upset. We never had the love that every child ought to get. We ain't no delinquents, we're misunderstood. Deep down inside us there is good.
There is good.
There is good, there is good, there is untapped good. Like inside the worst of us is good.
That's a touching good story.
Let me tell it to the world.
Just tell it to the judge.
Hey, the
come
judge,
on, you
kindly judge your honor, my parents treat me rough. With all the marijuana, they won't give me a puff. They didn't wanna have me, but somehow I was had. Leaping lizards, that's why I'm so bad.
Right, Officer Krupke, you're really a square. This boy don't need a judge, he needs an analyst's care. It's just his neurosis that ought to be curbed. He's psychologically disturbed.
I'm disturbed.
We're disturbed, we're disturbed, we're the most disturbed. Like we're psychologically disturbed.
Hear ye, hear ye. In the opinion of this court, this child is depraved on account of he ain't had a normal home.
Hey, I'm depraved on account I'm deprived.
So take him to a head shrinker.
Come on, you dumb
brother. My father is a bastard. My ma's an SOB. My grandpa's always plastered. My grandma pushes tea. My sister wears a mustache. My brother wears a dress. Goodness gracious, that's why I'm a mess.
Yes, Officer Krupke, you're really a slob. This boy don't need a doctor, just a good honest job. Society's played him a terrible trick, and sociologically he's sick.
I am sick.
We are sick. We are sick. We are sick, sick, sick. Like we're sociologically sick.
In my opinion, this child does not need to have his head shrunk at all. Juvenile delinquency is purely a social disease.
Hey, I got a social disease.
So take him to a social worker.
Social worker, yeah. Social.
Dear kindly social worker, they say go earn some dough, like be a soda jerker, which means like be a schmo. It's not I'm anti-social, I'm only anti-work. Glory Oski, that's why I'm a jerk.
Hey, Officer Krupke, you've done it again. This boy don't need a job, he needs a year in the pen. It ain't just a question of misunderstood. Deep down inside him, he's no good.
I'm no good.
We're no good, we're no good, we're no earthly good. Like the best of us is no damn good.
The trouble is he's lazy.
The trouble is he drinks.
The trouble is he's crazy.
The trouble is he stinks.
The trouble is he's growing.
The trouble is he's grown.
Krupke, we got troubles of our own. Gee, Officer Krupke, we're down on our knees. Officer Krupke, what are we to do? Gee, Officer Krupke, Krupke you!
What ever happened to my part? It was exciting at the start. Now we're halfway through Act Two, and I've had nothing yet to do. I've been off stage for far too long. It's ages since I had a song. This is one unhappy diva. The producers have deceived her. There is nothing I can sing from my heart. Whatever happened to my part? I am sick of my career, always stuck in second gear, up to here with frustration and with fears. I've no Grammy, no rewards. I've no Tony Awards. I'm constantly replaced by Britney Spears. Britney Spears. Whatever happened to my show? I was a hit, now I don't know. I'm with a bunch of British knights, prancing round in woolly. Well, they can kiss my tush. It seems to me they've really lost the plot. Whatever happened to my, I'll call my agent, damn it. Whatever happened to my, not yours, not yours, but mine.
Don't dare.
Girl, 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 I'm warning you. Oh, I think I have a crush. I can't. I think I'm falling for him. Oh no.
Why not? Women have been making bad choices since the beginning of time. Are you gonna be another one of mine? Oh. Used to think you were from outer space. Whose Abra I got in your place? You're kinda cute when you're not so shy. Oh. But I've been here before. Have I come back for more? Another chapter in the history of wrong guys. You used to be so high, I'll impact Mr. Gore. But now you're changing into something I just can't ignore. Charlie, honestly, I've been hurt like this before. Is there really more to you than what I always thought? How can you surprise me anymore? Oh, 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 oh. He's got a girlfriend you like. Why are they only nice when they're unavailable? Don't wanna be another star-crossed lover. We all know how that ends. I'm better off without him. We're better off as friends. Oh, oh, oh. But I've been here before. Have I come back for more? Another chapter in the history of wrong guys. Yesterday no spark, my heart aching galore. But today I'm feeling something. Bomb. Two, he's not into you. Three, he's a sleaze. Four,
Executized.
All right, listen. This mailbox is filled with checks, which we're gonna retrieve and wipe clean.
Isn't that check fraud?
I mean, what even is check fraud?
It's the fraudulent use of checks.
Merriam-Webster over here. Okay, let's review. How to wash a check. Tie the fish line. Open the mailbox. Drop the glue trap. Get a bite. Pull the line up. Take the check out. Make a copy. Do it right. Or nobody gets what they want. Nobody gets what they want. Sing it.
Nobody gets what they want.
In harmony.
Nobody gets what they want.
Okay. Next steps. Soak the checky in the solvent. Where'd the ink go?
Ooh.
Out of sight. Dry the check off. Forge the handcuff. To Seth Wheatus.
Wait, what?
Do it right.
Did you say Seth
Or everybody ends up in jail.
Oh, God.
Everybody ends up in jail. Tell me.
Everybody ends up in jail.
Remind me.
Everybody ends up in jail.
Good. Now you do it.
Tie the fish line.
Right.
Open the mailbox.
Good. Now the glue top. You didn't peel it.
Where's the fish?
What are you doing?
The line is tangled.
Jesus!
These fumes are strong.
What is happening?
Who has the glue trap? I can't peel it.
If you guys cock this up, nobody gets what they want! Nobody gets what they want!
Nobody gets what they want.
Can't I just reach in the mailbox? My arms are pretty skinny.
No, just do it like I said.
Got the fish line.
Got the glue trap.
Hand it over. It's so sticky.
I think my arm's stuck.
What?
Inside the mailbox.
Oh, shit, his arm's stuck.
Stuck in the mailbox.
I said not to do that.
Stuck in the mailbox.
I'm sorry.
Pull it out.
I can't.
Try to relax.
It's eating my arm.
The glue trap is stuck to my head.
How did you...
The glue trap is stuck to my head.
The glue trap is stuck to her head.
Of course it is.
The mailbox is eating my arm.
Kill me.
The mailbox is eating. The glue trap is stuck to... Everybody's going to jail. Everybody's going to jail. Sing it. Everybody's going to jail.
Oh, you know what? You're terrible at this. Maybe I should have recruited the show choir from West Orange.
No, we are better than West Orange. We can do this, you guys. Tenor, alto, bass, watch.
Tie the fish line, open the mailbox.
Drop the glue trap.
Get a bite.
Okay.
Pull the line up.
Take the check out.
Make a copy.
Do it right.
You're getting my hopes up.
Soak the checky.
Soak the checky.
Hello.
In the salt.
In the salt.
In the salt.
In the salt.
Where the ink goes.
Where the ink goes.
Where the ink goes.
I'm gonna
hurt
you.
Side to side.
Side to side.
Dry the check
floor.
Dry the check floor.
We
did it right.
I knew you would.
Yay!
Then you get the costumes you need.
Oh, whoa. We get the costumes we need.
Yeah, and Kim gets a family trip.
Oh, whoa.
didn't really need
anything. Doesn't matter.
Everybody gets what they want. Yeah.